Fox College Football comes to you from Horned Frog Country. They grill out a Saturday afternoon, turns to Saturday night, and they're expecting a fun Saturday night at Amon G. Carter Stadium. As the third-ranked team of the nation, the TCU Horned Frogs play host to the SMU Mustangs, the battle for the Iron Skillet, two schools separated by just 40 miles. Great to have you with us tonight with Brian Baldinger. I'm Mark Folliwell, and we're looking forward to this battle for the Iron Skillet. It's great to be here for a rivalry game. TCU starts thinking about Big 12 play next week. They've got a special season that they hope this is going to end up in. That will take care of itself in due time. The focus, though, for Trevon Boykin and company tonight is the SMU Mustangs.
It is, and you say you mentioned the operative word special because that's what Trevon Boykin is, and I just spent some time with him down on the field. He oozes with confidence. He's gone through a lot here. He's making his 32nd straight start. He believes in the system. He's got great players around him, and he's got a very good offensive line in front of him. So his whole thing is good decision making. And so far this year, he's been outstanding. And for SMU, new system, Chad Morris coming in. They're led by Matt Davis, who's really off to a very good start. Watching him on tape, he can beat you with his legs. He's averaging well over 100 yards a game running right now, but he also has a good arm. And tonight, the whole focus of TCU is to contain Matt Davis and not let him get loose.
SMU finally with a victory last week. The first for Chad Morris. They're 1-1 this year. TCU 2-0. They've won 10 straight games. The third-ranked Horned Frogs host the Mustangs. The kickoff of Fox College Football is next. TCU takes the field before their home crowd. A great atmosphere for college football right here in Fort Worth. Amon Carter Stadium, the Horned Frogs playing host to the SMU Mustangs. SMU the visitors tonight. The last time SMU won in this series, the battle for the Iron Skillet, was here in 2011. Gary Patterson, the longtime TCU head coach, 15th year, trying to go 90 games over 500. Patterson, 55 years old, from Roselle, Kansas, the fourth longest tenured coach in FBS. Meanwhile, it's a new coach for SMU, Chad Morris, with a lengthy resume as a high school football head coach here in the great state of Texas. He's been Clemson's offensive coordinator for the last 4 years. He takes over for June Jones at SMU, and so far, one in the win column, one in the loss column for Chad Morris. Jaden Overcrome will kick off for TCU. Brian, Braden West and Kevin Johnson are back deep to receive.
And Chad Morris wants to do on the hilltop what Gary Patterson has done here in Fort Worth.
And what a great program Gary Patterson has built here. Now in their fourth season of the Big 12, ranked number 3 in the nation. Jaden Overcrome starts off tonight's game with a touchback. And Matt Davis, the SMU quarterback, the junior from Klein Forest High School in Houston. 6 foot, 212 pounds, 4 touchdown passes this year, a couple of interceptions, completing 70% of his passes, Brian.
And it hasn't been an easy, you know, trek to get here. He started at Texas A&M. Johnny Manziel was there. Had to go to Tyler Junior College. Came here last year to SMU. Had to sit for a while. Started the last 5 games, and here he is. Quick snap right away.
And a quick toss right away. And a running play to start the game for the 25-yard line. Braden West, a freshman from Katy, Texas, outside of Houston.
Well, you can see that with Chad Morris as the offensive coordinator, you can get a quick sugar huddle like that, line up, play fast, huddle up, play slow. Ultimately, they want to run the ball and control the clock and play keep away from the Horned Frogs.
They ran for 3 yards on first down. The ratio this year for SMU, they're running 53 times a game. They're passing 24 times. And here's a quick sweep moving to the right side and forced out of bounds. Braden West, another 3-yard run, bringing up third down at about 3 or 4 yards to go. First, there's a flag, and so for the first time tonight, we'll hear from Adam Savoy, the referee.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense number 18, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Nick Orr with the personal foul, Brian, and there will be no third down play coming up as Orr pushes Braden West after he had taken a step or two out of bounds.
Well, just a penalty of aggression for Nick Orr, who's starting at safety tonight alongside Derek Kendrick, was starting at corner the first 2 weeks of the season.
Moves Terrence Mosley into the starting lineup, Torrance Mosley, that is, into the starting lineup at corner for TCU. And now Davis is able to escape the pressure. And Davis to the sideline and running for the second SMU first down on this opening drive. Forced out of bounds by Orr. No penalty that time, but a big chunk of yardage for Davis.
And they're going to huddle up here. That's the signal. Gary Patterson won't be happy about that. Because I sat in their film sessions yesterday with Gary going over the reminder saying, look, make Matt Davis beat us throwing the football. We've got to contain him. You got to kind of control yourself when he has the ball because he's so electric.
That was a 19-yard run. Now Davis from the 34. Throwing the ball to the end zone. And there is a flag down in the corner of the end zone. And the incomplete pass, but a marker down as they were trying to find the rangy
pass
freshman receiver, Cortland Sutton.
Defense number three, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, that's Torrance Mosley you just mentioned starting at that corner against Cortland Sutton, who's their big play young player right here. He's got three touchdown catches the first 2 weeks of the season. In fact, the first play of the season for SMU against Baylor 2 weeks ago, he caught the first play for a long touchdown against Baylor.
Now to 19, two 15-yard penalties in this opening drive have helped SMU advance the ball, and they are in the red zone. Braden West running on first down, short pickup as we look at the Academy Sports and Outdoors White Stuff Key Players of the Game.
Well, we just mentioned Cortland Sutton, who's averaging 18 yards a catch. Really a breakout season for him, and they're led TCU by their senior safety, Darren Kindred, a man they just call Peanut, affectionately. Peanut. Good nickname, heck of a player, good leader on this defense.
Returning leading tackler from last year's defense. The run on first down for West was 2 yards, a play fake. Time to throw. Now Matt Davis making moves, keeping the ball back to the line of scrimmage. All of that nets no gain. Josh Caraway brought him down.
Now he had time to be the sandwich back there, right? But watch the rush here of TCU. They're not trying to get to him. They're trying to contain him, keep him in front of him. So he's doing all this back there like a jackrabbit, and ultimately they got what they wanted. They got a no gain on that play, even though he had all that time. They don't believe that Matt Davis sees the field real well. He's more interested in running, and that rush is exactly what Gary Patterson wanted.
Now TCU in an advantageous position defensively. They are allowing opponents to convert only 19% of third downs this year. This is third down, almost nine. Davis steps up in the pocket, throws on the move, and a completed pass inside the five-yard line to Kevin Thomas, all the way down to the one where it will be first and goal.
I tell you what, this Matt Davis, we said he's dynamic, but he's already shown us three or four plays in this opening drive. Watch right now. I mean, the bush rush is coming. They're going to try and keep him in the pocket. They think they have. But you know what? You can't rip the flag off him. He keeps the flag alive. And let's face it, you can't cover down the field for 5 seconds. Guy's going to uncover.
Kevin Thomas, second catch of the season. Freshman wide receiver from DeSoto. Xavier Jones is in the backfield. This is officially at the two for first and goal, and they hand it off to the freshman, Xavier Jones, punching into the middle of the line, and he has scored for SMU to open the game.
Well, already, in less than 4 minutes, SMU already did something they couldn't do at all last year. In a 56-0 defeat, you're going to see Xavier Jones, a true freshman, and they really like both these backs. Xavier Jones, who just scored, along with Braden West, we saw them both on this opening drive.
Jones plunges in for his second touchdown run of the year.
This may get reviewed, huh?
I think you're right, Brian.
The previous play is under further review.
You know, way back when, in the early 80s, they had the Pony Express, Eric Dickerson and Craig James, and that was a heck of a duo, winning the Southwest Conference, ranking high in the country. See if you could cross this line. We get a good angle here.
I don't know if there's going to be enough to be able to tell. I think he was over. Someone drives him back, but I think the ball did barely break the plane of the goal.
There won't be enough evidence to overturn this. But mentioning the Pony Express from the early 80s, I mean, they believe that Xavier Jones and Braden West have a chance. Now, maybe not in Eric Dickerson, who sits in the Hall of Fame, However, they believe these two can be a 1-2 punch for years to come here at SMU.
Straight from the head coach, Chad Morris. When we talked to him earlier this week, Brian, he said, when I talk about these two freshmen, I get really giddy about Xavier Jones and Braden West.
Well, I think Chad Morris gets giddy about a lot of things. You know, I mean, he knows how many seconds are in a day, you know, because every second he should be recruiting, and that's what he wanted. That was an unbelievable opening drive, and he did this kind of magic at Clemson for the last 4 years. They had them ranked high year after year. Taj Boyd, great quarterback, great receiver, Sammy Watkins, DeAndre Hopkins. He's used to coaching very talented players.
The first quarter points allowed in this young season by TCU's defense. An SMU drive of 75 yards, aided by a couple of TCU penalties. And now Chad Hedlund, he's from Argyle, Texas, a transfer from Wake Forest. He's on for the extra point, and SMU has a 7-0 lead just over 3 minutes into the game. SMU has made the trip across the Metroplex from Dallas to Fort Worth, and making the trip across the goal line was Xavier Jones to cap that drive. SMU, with a battle for the Iron Skillet, takes the lead. SMU's fans who have made the trek to Fort Worth, an opening drive of 7 plays, 75 yards. The last 2 yards covered by Xavier Jones. But TCU was penalized twice on the drive, a hit out of bounds and a pass interference call. Already 30 yards in penalties for Gary Patterson's team, who averages 46.5 yards in penalties per game, 6 flags per game for those 46.5 yards in penalties. Now Chad Hedlund is ready to kick off. Brian, Kevonte Turpin, Colby Lissabe, they're back deep to receive. And Turpin, who's been running back punts, is running back the kickoff, and he took it from 3 or 4 yards deep in the end zone, and had he downed it, that's where they would be, right at the 25. Carlos Carroll on special teams with a tackle.
Well, we get an early look here at Trevon Boykin and all the publicity that surrounded him in that tremendous breakout season a year ago throughout the offseason. All he's done is just gone to work every day under, you know, a new regime, and Doug Meacham, and along with Sonny Meacham, or
Sonny Cumbie,
like, they've just done a good job of just kind of grooming him and bringing him along and teaching him this offense, and he's flourished it.
Aaron Green is the running back and a 4-receiver set. The kick return was right to the 25, and Boykin is throwing through the hands of Desmond White and came close to being intercepted.
Well, that's the one area of the field that Trevon Boykin wanted to get better at. Throw the ball in the middle of the field, he does. I mean, that ball's right through the hands of Desmond White. Maybe a little higher than he wants. Desmond White only stands 5'7". He's got to lower that ball just a little bit, maybe.
So far this year, Boykin has completed 64% of his passes. The game starts with an incompletion. He looked left. He went to the screen pass. Oh, that is close to an interception. It's an incompletion, but very close to an interception. The closest player for TCU, Brian, was the offensive lineman, Halapuli Vati Vaitai, and Zach Wood almost picked it off.
There was no back there. In fact, the ball was thrown to his left tackle. You see, I mean, well, you can see Aaron Green was behind him. That's a dangerous throw.
Oh, my.
Zach Wood down on the ground.
Oh, that all, I mean, a gift just almost literally fell right to him down on the ground.
I don't know if he lost his. So Trevon Boykin 0 for 2 to start here. He doesn't get flustered easily. The first pass, I think, was a drop. The second one, they kind of played the screen. They couldn't see Aaron Green coming out. Doug Meacham, the offensive coordinator, co-coordinator, along with Sonny Cumbie.
And, of course, folks that follow the Big 12 will remember Sonny Cumbie from his days as a quarterback to Mike Leach at Texas Tech.
Sure. Doug Meacham just been around this conference, Oklahoma State.
Also coached in Texas at Houston. Now third down and 10. After two incompletions, Boykin's pass here is on the money, and Ty Slanina gets a foot down and bounds for a TCU first down out to the 39, a gain of 14.
Well, he ripped that one. You know, on third and 10, after two incompletions, he let it fly. He got it to his slot receiver.
And they can go as fast as anybody in this style of offense.
And for Ty Slonina, that's his fifth catch of the season. And they do go fast. And they will go deep. And Boykin with a pretty pass. But either Colby Listenby, with all of his speed, could not run it down. As we look at the Academy Sports and Outdoors key impact players of the game.
And isn't it funny how that graphic just shows up? And there's Colby Listenby, who's got literally world-class speed. 10 flat, 100 meters. The stuff that Usain Bolt runs with. And Darren Richardson leads this team in tackles at the safety position. Wants to try to make every single tackle in the field aggressive play.
Richardson had one pick last season, has one interception so far this year. SMU has lost to Baylor and then defeated North Texas 31-13 last week. Out of the backfield, a catch for Kevontae Turpin. And Turpin turns on the Jets and will run it all the way into the end zone. Touchdown, TCU! Well, Brian, it took a couple of plays for the TCU offense to get on track, but when they got on track, they found a way to quickly find the end zone.
Well, this is an offense that scored almost 50 points a game last year. I mean, Kevontae Turpin caught him in a blitz, one-on-one coverage, beat the coverage, and then you see the world-class speed he has to really outrun the defense for the touchdown.
Jaden Overcrome now with the extra point. And just like SMU, a 75-yard drive culminating in a touchdown for TCU. Kevontae Turpin is a freshman from Monroe, Louisiana, and that's his sixth catch of the season, his second touchdown reception, as it goes for 61 yards. Visit your local Texas Ford dealer. Ford is the best in Texas. One of the great accomplishments in a decade and a half for Gary Patterson here at TCU, winning the Rose Bowl over Wisconsin, New Year's Day 2011 in Pasadena. And part of their calling card has always been defense. They're allowing 254 yards a game so far this year. SMU is almost halfway there. One touchdown drive and another one that is threatening to end up in the end zone. Third down and six at the 10. And the quick pitch. And they've got it strung out. But Brayden West turns the ball up the field and is stopped short of the first down. But did pick up 5 yards to the five before Aaron Curry slams him down.
And that's a play Gary Patterson calls Cheetos. They're cheating it, and then the off-guard pulls, and here it is. You're going to see just a little pull, get the defense to come to Matt Davis, and a little pitch. But this is all Brayden West. They've got three players that are going to stop him right there. He puts that left foot in the ground, and boom, hits the hole like that and gains some good yards.
And wanting to ensure coming away from this drive with points on fourth and a yard, SMU will opt for, apparently will opt for a field goal. Chad Hedlund from 23 yards, and it's on the money. Hedlund is now 2 for 2 on field goals this year. Matt Davis engineers a drive that gets all the way down to 5. His counterpart, Trevon Boykin, will be on the field for the second time in the game. The Heisman hopeful threw a touchdown pass on the first drive of the game. The TCU offense back on the field after this. From Chad Hedlund, 10-7, the lead for SMU. TCU had given up only 3 points in the first half against Minnesota and Stephen F. Austin so far this year. But 10 points scored in the opening 10 minutes of the game by SMU.
Well, you know, I think one thing that Gary Patterson wanted to try to, you know, make sure his players understood, they won 56-0 against SMU last year. They scored 70 last week. Is you can't get relaxed, confident, start looking ahead to the conference schedule next week. I mean, SMU comes here looking for an upset, trying to make a name for itself early this season.
The conference schedule, by the way, for TCU starts on the road next week at Texas Tech. Chad Hedlund kicking off. And a run back by Kevontae Turpin, who scored the touchdown for TCU. And he does have some moves. Carlos Carroll drills Turpin on the return, but the run all the way out to the 39-yard line. Trevon Boykin. And the offense will take the field now for the second time. Here is the improvement by Boykin from West Mesquite High School and how he's been able to each year get better and better, Brian.
Yeah, but the numbers really don't tell the story. We saw him in 2013 and 2012. And there's nobody that thought that he could be a Heisman Trophy candidate, could lead this team to the playoffs. I mean, this transformation is amazing. And it's a credit to Doug Meacham, to Sonny Cumbie, and to the the persistence of Trevon Boykin to just stay after it and believe in himself.
On the 38, after a nice run back by Turpin on the kickoff, Boykin is 2 for 5. They still haven't run the ball in the game, but this will go down as a rush because he'll go down, sacked by Justin Lawler for SMU.
Nice job by Lawler, who I really think is a good player, just a sophomore. And, I mean, he's just going to stay after it right now. He's at the bottom of your screen right now. Just keeps staying after it. Persistence right there. That's just a four-man rush in a sack of Boykin.
And it's a loss of 6 yards back to the 32. Second down and 16. Now Boykin running, spinning, and then drilled. Forced out of bounds ultimately, but a big hit delivered by Jordan Wyatt on defense for the Mustangs.
And really, that's the first official run for TCU tonight. But really good job by Lawler of turning Boykin inside and then right into the safety, Jordan Wyatt, forcing this third and long.
Third and 10.
One guy we haven't seen tonight is Josh Doxson. That's their leading receiver. He's down at the bottom, 3-by-1 set. He'll get the one-on-one coverage against Jesse Montgomery.
The sack a moment ago for Justin Lawler was his second one this season, only the third allowed by TCU in 2 games and a quarter. Boykin got back the yardage, lost on the sack, so they have 30-10. Escapes the pressure, running the ball, a seam to run, and then falls forward for the first down as he has the ball over midfield into SMU territory.
Well, he wanted to go to Doxson at the bottom, but he was well covered. And so he turned it back inside, and then he's looking down the field, keeping his eyes alive. And really, the turf monster is what tackled him on that play.
He tripped over the 50.
Yeah.
But not before he ran it for 16 yards on third and 10. With 3 minutes left in the first quarter. TCU has scored a touchdown in 16 straight first quarters with their score tonight. Aaron Green runs the ball down to the 40 of SMU. First time we've seen Green carry the ball. Shaquille Randolph on the tackle. Aaron Green has 108 yards in the first 2 games. Quick snap. And Boykin will throw the deep ball. Oh, he's got Josh Doxson wide open. Falling into the end zone. They'll spot him down inside the 1-yard line.
He just cut that one loose. Put a lot of air under the ball. Got it to his leading receiver. The coverage just broke down. I mean, he was wide open. He just cuts this loose, and that's Montgomery, the field corner, chasing him and nowhere near him.
And now a running play for a touchdown, Aaron Green.
Well, you can see the explosiveness that TCU has, and from anywhere on the field, they can just strike, and they just make you play perfect assignment football. When it breaks down, they catch you, and that's the experience and the eyes and the poise of Trevon Boykin.
Aaron Green gets to take it in the final yard after a 39-yard pass from Trevon Boykin to Josh Doxson. Put TCU on the lip of the cup. Arlington Martin High School's Jaden Overcrome makes it 14-10, hitting the extra point. 62-yard drive, 39 yards covered here, Baldy.
Look at that ball spin coming into your living room. Doxson desperately trying to get into the end zone, but you know what? They'll give it to the senior back, Aaron Green, let him score. Walked right behind the right guard, Brady Foltz, captain tonight. Senior dominant offensive line. What a breakout season a year ago for TCU, the offense, a decision by Gary Patterson sometime in November of 2013, scratching his head going, we got to change our philosophy around here. And he went out and called up Doug Meacham, told him, come on, run your offense here. I'll give you a carte blanche. He went and got himself Sonny Cumbie. They kind of threw it together as a team. And it has really elevated this program to a whole different level.
The result last year, Baldy, 46.5 points a game, second in the nation,
yeah.
533 yards, fifth in the nation, 326 of those yards through the air, seventh best in the country. Jaden Overcrome kicking off, 5 yards deep in the end zone. Great West will take a knee. TCU leads for the first time of the game, 14-10. Here's Leslie McCaslin.
guys, remember, this TCU defense has lost five starters just since the beginning of this season. Gary Patterson has played not one but two freshmen for the first time in his career ever. Now, guys, I see him over on the sidelines after that last break doing a lot of teaching, going up to every one of his defensive players, telling them when and where they made mistakes on that last SMU drive. So he's got a lot of young players. He's got to coach them up right now early on here in the season.
Well, Leslie was speaking just a moment ago. You saw the list of injured defensive players. There's a first down handoff. Racing up over the 20-yard line is Xavier Jones. And don't forget the talent that left through graduation, Brian.
Oh, yeah.
Marcus Mallett, Paul Dawson, P.J. Dawson now. Chris Hackett, seven interceptions last year.
Kevin
Sam
White.
Carter, Kevin White. Chucky Hunter on the defensive line as well.
Yeah, but, you know, Gary Patterson is in his 16th year. That's what he does. He reloads. He just keeps training them. He believes in his players. Sometimes you got to go from safety to linebacker like Montrell Wilson has.
And a quick throw and a drop. A drop for Shelby Walker on second down and nine.
And coming was a man they call Peanut. Derek Kindred, the free safety, the leading tackler, returning senior in that secondary. That head is down. He's going right for the ball. If you hang in, Todd, he was going to separate him from the ball. Good football player in the back end of his defense.
Walker, a sophomore, had a chance for his second catch of the season. But the drop leaves SMU with third down and nine. They've been great at converting third downs, though, so far in the game.
Boy, playing back here, playing the sticks. All the linebackers back. Eyes are on Matt Davis.
Number 26, and down he goes. Matt Davis finally wrestled in the turf. Josh Carraway, junior from Flower Mound, Marcus with the sack.
Stop. They kind of turned it loose here on the third and line. They didn't mush rush that time. Carraway's going to be coming from your right side of the screen. Really, Matt Davis ran right into him. Kind of rushed that one a little bit. First time today that they've gotten to Davis. First time today that they've shut down this SMU attack.
From Rowlett, Texas, Josh Williams. Averaging almost 41 yards on eight punts so far this season. He'll punt for the first time tonight in the last minute of the first quarter. And Kevontae Turpin is back deep to receive. He's looked good returning punts this year. He'll have a chance to do something with this. Caught it at the 42. There's a marker down. This is still going to be a pretty special-looking return, but I do believe it will be coming back based on where the flag was thrown right around midfield.
It's coming back, but boy, I tell you, he is fun to watch. He's so slippery, silky smooth.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Receiving team number 31, 10-yard penalty, first down.
You know, Mark, the Big 12 lost one of the great returners in the history of this conference in Tyler Lockett. This kid reminds me of Tyler Lockett. Now you got to get a clip. You see the number in the back, you just don't hit it. But this guy's got a change of direction, gears. That Tyler Lockett took a punt back last week for a touchdown for Seattle against St. Louis.
39 seconds left of the first quarter. TCU, third ranked in the country, leads SMU 14-10. And this SMU-TCU game is being broadcast on AFN, the American Forces Network, broadcasting to the U.S. Armed Forces, serving around the world on land and on ships at sea. We welcome you to Amon G. Carter Stadium in Fort Worth, Texas.
What a beautifully renovated stadium right here on the campus of TCU. A great night for football.
Fourth year since the major renovation project. After the penalty, here's a first down pass. Josh Dotson, nice spin move. Racing for the sideline, Dotson with another big game. Forrest Richardson forced him out of bounds, but Josh Dotson strikes again.
Well, he catches, I mean, this ball is just a strike. Now, look at him put that right foot in the ground, spin away from Horace Richardson. A little stiff arm, still trying to get into the end zone.
Already has a 39-yard grab tonight. Now 54 yards for Josh Dotson. TCU has first and goal at the 7. And they've gone Wildcat. Sean Nixon is in the game. And Nixon was wrestled down after a short pickup. Robert Seals.
You know, going back to Dotson, who's coming back in the game. What a story. We'll get to it as we get ready for the second quarter.
Well, he's already up to 250 receiving yards for the season. 39 and 54 is two big grabs in the first quarter tonight, and he's got TCU in scoring position again. But SMU has certainly held their own so far. And through one quarter, the battle for the Iron Skillet favors TCU. Fortunes are ready for TCU, and they have struck with big plays often.
Well, that's when Javonte Kirkland catch over the middle, 61-yard touchdown, Boykin in the open field, and then this throw here to Josh Doctson takes him down to the one-yard line. I mean, they can explode from anywhere on the field. They got a quarterback with a big arm, they got receivers with speed, and probably the most important, besides some great-looking cheerleaders, they got an offensive line that gives time for all that stuff to develop.
Averaging 12 yards per play, a 14-10 lead on the scoreboard, running some misdirection. They faked a sweep. They went inside to Aaron Green, and SMU was on it. Jarvis Pruitt.
The only thing I would say, if I, you know, had to critique TCU in the first quarter, was I think sometimes they get too fancy with the Wildcat. Keep the ball in Trevon Boykin's hands. He's special.
Forward to the Heisman voting last year. Boykin is dropping a throw. Has to step up under pressure. And is upended at the 47 of SMU. He gets pinwheeled by Kyron Mitchell on the tackle.
Like nothing. Look at this flip. Man, that is dangerous. But he got that left hand down to break the fall. Wow. We are seeing athletes on this field tonight all over the place.
That was a 7-yard step up and run for Boykin. TCU now has 32 yards rushing. Most of their offense has been in the passing game. And here's a whole lot more in the passing game on the quick hitter to Kevontae Turpin to the SMU 29-yard line.
Well, Kevontae Turpin, we're going to hear a lot about this young, true freshman. There he is lining up the tailback right now. Right behind Boykin.
18 yards and a quick pass by Boykin. Oh, and a big hit delivered by David Johnson on a pass intended for Jawan Story, who might have heard the proverbial footsteps.
Well, maybe, but that's the way that you break up these hitches on the outside. I mean, you just come and attack it. While it's getting there, you hit him. Now, you're right. You know, that ball already bounced off him before Johnson got there. But that's one way you kind of stop some of that perimeter game. Boykin just been flipped upside down, power pistol formation here.
Play fake, looking for another big play to Doctson. Oh, the pass on the money. Touchdown, TCU.
This offense is pretty good. I tell you, Trevon Boykin, he doesn't get tired, he doesn't get rattled, he plays with poise. And that deep ball, that ball spins. It is a tight spiral. He has improved as much as any player in this country over the last 2 years.
How about Josh Doctson? Three catches, 122 yards, and he finally gets one into the end zone. Trevon Boykin, by the way, has passed Max Naki for second and completions in TCU history. Here he is, though, running and getting upended by Kyron Mitchell. And then he puts one right on the button to Josh Doctson. 29-yard touchdown, TCU up 11. ...21-10 is the lead for TCU over SMU with 8 minutes left of the second quarter. TCU on offense after a very short punt by Josh Williams. Trying to keep the ball away from Kevontae Turpin. 43-yard line is where this drive will start. Trevon Boykin has already thrown for over 200 yards. Another 2,400 approximately needed this season to pass Andy Dalton for number one in TCU history. There's Aaron Green with that run. We've seen a lot of Turpin tonight making big plays happen, but that's Aaron Green running the ball for TCU to the SMU 37, and they'll go quick tempo. Reverse, Slanina. Boykin trying to get in the way and throw a block, and Slanina is forced out of bounds.
Doug Meek is making the calls, and so right now he just actually told Boykin next to him what the play is going to be. But Boykin's getting everybody lined up as he surveys the defense here, and part of playing quarterback in his fast tempo system is making good decisions before the ball snap, and then once it snapped, what to do with the ball.
31-yard line of SMU. Second down at 4, TCU. Boykin. Flushed here and lowers his head and absorbs a pretty big hit from Shaquille Randolph, but is right at the sticks for a first down. Third down and a yard, coming up just short. Boykin may be changing the play here. They're going to run option. Oh, and a pitch, and he lost it. He's back on top of it, but a lot of yardage lost by Boykin. And Robert Seals almost recovered a fumble, but did force a big negative play.
This doesn't happen much in this operation, but Boykin right here, that's a great play defensively on the outside by Lawler. Or by
Seals.
Seals, yeah. Seals
Robert
making
Seals.
That play, yeah. I mean, that's one way to stop that offense. There was just penetration, and just as Boykin was ready to pitch, Seals was right there.
Last week, the first punt for Ethan Perry was a shank against Stephen F. Austin, only 14 yards. He's going to try to pin them deep. SMU didn't even have anyone back to return. It's going to take a roll here. And listen, B, because of that high hop, like a shortstop trying to field a bad hop grounder, couldn't keep it out of the end zone.
But all the coaching point here is on this hop, just bat it back in bounds. Just bat it. Don't try to catch it here. Oh. It was a bad hop, though.
It's two of the biggest names in the UFC face off as coaches as interim featherweight champ Conor McGregor and Uriah Faber join an all-new season of The Ultimate Fighter. The mayhem continues Wednesday only on FS1. SMU's first two drives resulted in 10 points on 21 plays. Last three drives, only a total of 13 plays, all ending in punts. We'll see what they can string together here after a touchback on the punt and trying to make a man miss is Raheem Malone. The purple shirts swarm him. Denzel Johnson leads the charge along with Derek Kendrick. 2 yards on the pass play to Malone.
What a play by Nick Orr, who's out there for Tejada right now in corner.
He moved back to corner.
He started at corner, then went to safety. Now he's back at corner. He's got Sutton on him right now. He's been their big play receiver and deep threat.
A lane for Matt Davis to run on second down and 8. He faked the handoff, and a lot of room for Davis to run all the way to the 39.
Well, they completely fooled the nickelback Denzel Johnson that time. That's going to upset that man, Gary Patterson. Good fake right there. I mean, you can see, just fooled two players on the outside.
Xavier Jones is in the backfield. This is at the 39. We'll see if Davis is going to cut it loose. As zip it over the middle. This one's caught. Holding on to it this time after an earlier drop is Shelby Walker, and SMU on the move into TCU territory.
And that was a dart by Davis, and what a great job protecting Davis that time. Really, the offensive line here of SMU gave us plenty of time to survey and find Walker.
15 yards to Shelby Walker, sophomore receiver. 7 catches last year, 2 this year. Running the ball here is Xavier Jones. He has the only SMU touchdown tonight, and he's able to maneuver his way to the sideline. And with that run, very close to a first down. Like he'll be just a little bit short.
Blocking on the outside that time by Sutton, along with the lead block. Well executed.
At the 37 of TCU. Went down to take a shot, but Davis will dump it off, and it's incomplete. looking for Xavier Jones out of the backfield.
He probably wishes he would have just kept it himself. Nothing with trying to check it down to Xavier Jones there on that play, but boy, he had a lane to run as well.
That he did.
They are chasing Matt Davis all over the field, and he's just as elusive as can be. His conditioning is phenomenal. Doesn't look like he is fatigued at all in this heat and humidity.
And a 191-yard rushing day last year when SMU got off the schneid in the season finale and beat Connecticut. Now Davis is handing it off, and Xavier Jones started to dart inside, cut to the outside. Flag is down. He picked up the first down and probably some more yardage tacked on at the end.
Probably a late hit that time. L.J. Collier chasing him.
Holding. Offense, number 16. 10-yard penalty. Third down.
Well, it's Sutton, the receiver, on the edge.
Yeah, huh? He's checking with the officials about a lot of things. Offensive pass interference. Now holding on the outside. That might have been Kevin Thomas on the outside. I think this is where it might be. Kevin Thomas. Yeah, he's grabbing the jersey. That's the call. It's not Sutton. Good replay that time by our director, Phil Molica, and his crew. Getting a good shot of that.
Now backed up to the 41 on third down and long. And Davis fires, incomplete.
That's Kindred cutting across and making that play. The senior safety, their leading tackler.
Trying to find Shelby Walker.
They're kind of like in that no man's land here. 41-yard line. Do they go for it here on fourth down? Kindred having a heck of a day. I guess everybody calls him Peanut, you know, at TCU. Maybe we should start doing it as well.
Boy, the penalties have been so costly in this game for SMU in terms of cutting short drives on offense. Braden West is in the backfield, and this is SMU going for it. And they call a timeout on fourth and five. Second timeout call by SMU here in the first half as we go to Jenny Taft in L.A. with a Fox College football game break.
Well, thanks, Mark. Just behind TCU in the polls, number six USC hosting Stanford, and Heisman hopeful Cody Kessler finds Juju Smith-Schuster, and he does the rest. Dives in for the 54-yard touchdown. Trojans lead 21-17 in the second quarter. Mark Bryan, back to you. Fourth word.
Cody Kessler certainly getting some recognition in the Heisman race.
Sure is, and I've got two quarterbacks on my Heisman watch list. We'll get to it later in the game. Both Trevon Boykin, of course. Nice afternoon or nice evening here tonight for him. Cody Kessler at USC, along with three really good running backs.
But like baseball, you can't win the pennant in April. The Heisman Trophy, you're not going to win it in September, but you can certainly get yourself noticed at least.
You get yourself your notice. If you remember when Johnny Manziel won it 3 years ago, it was that day in Tuscaloosa when he took down the Crimson Tide that afternoon that he jumped up to be the favorite.
The TCU fans jumping up here with SMU going for it on fourth down. 5 yards to go at the Horned Frog 41 after a timeout. Davis hit as he throws. He's going for all of it. Broken up looking for Cortland Sutton at the goal line. And a hit delivered by Montrell Wilson right whenever Davis was releasing the pass.
And it was good coverage on the play. I mean, you're going to see just squeezing Sutton here, just working. Nick Orr, we talked about him a lot. I mean, it's just a tough throw. And Montrell Wilson, the rookie, the freshman, just keeps coming. I just think SMU needs to find that intermediate route. I mean, it's either been all or nothing right now in the passing game. Somebody underneath, especially on fourth and five, to try to keep a drive alive is what Chad Morris needs to find here in the second half.
Even if Sutton makes the grab, wouldn't have counted. You see the official throw his hat. The referee had thrown his hat. He'd gone out of bounds. Turnover on downs for SMU with 3:34 left in the first half. TCU good field position, and Boykin with a dart to Ty Slanina, quickly wrestled down by Darian Richardson.
And we talked to Sonny Cumby yesterday. The development of Teron Boykin with throwing the ball over the middle of the field into the teeth of the defense, that's one of the areas where he's excelling and improving. There's Sonny in the visor there, former Texas Tech quarterback. Co-coordinator, he's the eyes upstairs in the booth.
34 years old, went to high school in Snyder, Texas. Well, the 41 to the 41, 18 yards on that play. And a dump off underneath. Aaron Green will make the catch. Jordan White pushed him out, Brian.
Javon just has a pretty release. Ball just comes out clean. It's a tight spiral. It's effortless. Doug Beecham will tell you. He came here. All right, they were 4-8, but the cupboard wasn't bare. He had a lot to work with, including a very talented offensive line led by that man, Joey Hunt, and that man, the quarterback, Javon Boykin.
You weren't just looking at shelf paper
whenever
you opened up that cupboard.
No.
Second down and 4. Green will bounce it outside. First down. Going back inside. Wyatt on the tackle, but not before. This is punched into the red zone. 19-yard line of SMU.
Kevontae Turpin coming into the game. Going to line up to the right of Trevon Boykin. Look out for this man. The freshman, number 25.
Officially, this will be at the 20. With 2:20 left in the half. Joey Hunt down over the ball on the snap to Boykin. Oh, and Heat. He got away, though. Wow. What elusiveness. Now Boykin is going to run it for the end zone. He did. Touchdown.
Yeah, strike up the band. I don't know how he got out of the tackle, Horton. I mean, they lassoed him. They had the rope all around him.
Nick Horton doesn't know either how he got out of the tackle.
No, he had a hole in his glove. But Boykin sure is exciting.
Jaden Overcrone with the extra point. 21 straight points scored by TCU since SMU had a 10-7 lead.
Well, you're going to see Horton. Here he comes. Number 5, he's got him up the upper body, shakes him off, but now look at him regain his poise here. He looks down the field, sees the lane, and I was like, I can score, yeah. Wow. There's some quarterbacks that are great runners in this country. There's some quarterbacks that are great throwers. There's not many quarterbacks that can elude the rush like that and then finish a play like this. And back before he was a Heisman Trophy candidate, I thought he could have been the best running back at TCU. I thought he could have been the best receiver at TCU. And he did all those things. But now he's combined it all. And I said at the beginning, he oozes with confidence. And he's got that look, that it factor. People want to be around him. He's a leader. He wants to get better. It's going to be an exciting season ahead of him.
242 passing yards, 38 rushing yards, 20 there for the touchdown. Again, 21 straight points for TCU. And the third-ranked Horned Frogs get a big boot here from Overcrone, and Braden West will down it in the end zone. We've had quite a game tonight. Trevon Boykin has been leading the attack for TCU. Here he is getting pinwheeled by Kyron Mitchell.
What's his body made out of? Like rubber? You know, getting the ball to Josh Doxson, his leading receiver. Beautiful throw there as he cuts it loose. Beats the coverage. Matt Davis trying to keep SMU alive, making his share of plays. A couple of exciting quarterbacks on the field tonight.
I think more is happening for SMU if they haven't hurt themselves with penalties on offense.
I agree.
I know you felt like the offensive pass interference maybe shouldn't have been called in an earlier drive. There's been a hold that's negated a couple of plays that would have gone for first downs. Now Davis, and there it is again. The home run ball. Oh, and he drops it into Malone. Malone down the sideline, and it takes two Horned Frog defenders to wrestle him out of bounds.
What a throw to Raheem Malone. It was a dart. Every ball was in the air over 50 yards. Right into the breadbasket here. What a throw over the outside shoulder. I mean, on that play, Mosley can't cover him any better.
Well, TCU has delivered some big punches here in the first half, but SMU trying to throw some haymakers. 64 yards all the way down to the TCU 12. And a big hole opens up for Braden West down to the 5.
Now maybe Chad Morris would rethink this slow down approach, a little huddle up, we'll play keep away. down 18 here. They have explosive players and a quarterback that can take advantage of.
Officially 63 on the pass to Malone. Davis has thrown for 148 yards.
Bringing the guard, Braylon Hyder, right now to right guard.
West inside the five. They don't need a touchdown for a first down.
That was a safety blitz that time. Michael Downey at the line of scrimmage, called by that man who calls all the defenses, does all the walkthroughs, all the film study. Downey right where he needed to be. He cut that play off before it started.
Gary Patterson told us yesterday they'd have an hour walkthrough this morning, another 15-minute walkthrough this afternoon.
They load the robot all week long so he can play faster on Saturday nights.
Needing 3 yards on third down. And Davis looked to the end zone. Closing speed for the perimeter. Davis is able to bounce off tackles, trying to stretch it forward for a first down. Where will they spot him?
Well, they flattened him right to the sideline. Tremendous speed by TCU on defense. He's going to be short. Nice chase this time by Paul Whitmill, who was a fullback just a couple weeks ago. You mentioned all the injuries.
Ty Summers ended up forcing him out of bounds, and it will be fourth down and a yard. 26 seconds left in the first half, and TCU will take a timeout. This is the first timeout that TCU has burned here in the opening half. 28-10, the Horned Frogs, ranked third in the country, lead the game. Coming up tonight on the Fox College Football Halftime Show, Rob Stone, Matt Leinart, and Dave Wanstead are in the studio. Michigan State, ranked fourth in the country. Big win last week. State played Air Force today. Highlights from Oklahoma and Tulsa. Baker Mayfield, I suspect, will be in a lot of those highlights.
Yeah.
And a look at a game tonight out west. Two ranked teams, BYU and UCLA.
In this Big 12, Gary Patterson can coach defense as well as anybody in this country. But this is an offensive conference. Everybody can put up points. We've seen three Big 12 teams in a row, West Virginia, Texas Tech, and now TCU. They all can explode. Who can slow one another down this year as you get ready for conference play?
SMU still has one timeout. If they convert the first down, the clock will stop to move the chains. It's fourth down and less than a yard. Snapping it, SMU at the Horned Frog 3. And Prescott line. They go to the big burly back, and he's able to charge forward for a first down.
Well, it's nice to have a 240-pound back that you can rely on. Call the timeout here with 20 seconds to go. This is just power football. Right behind Lasecki, the center. There
timeout.
He is.
SMU. Went right third and final.
Run right into the backside of Lasecki.
Right.
Yeah, nice push in the middle there. Inside the 1 yard line here, I'd go right back to the same play. No, I'd run Prescott line right in the middle.
If it doesn't work with 20 seconds on the clock, then presumably there's time to get back up to the line of scrimmage
still
and
kill
clock it.
Still kill it. You're inside a yard. I mean, obviously, the option to throw it, you know, it's going to stop. But I just think line right now, just behind what they did, put the ball in Davis's hands as a two-way threat. That's the smallest chart I've seen any coach have. You think he's trying to get their attention?
He has worked up quite a sweat on this humid night.
He does.
Gary Patterson has.
He does that every day, though. I mean, he never stops energizing and coaching his troops. Not going to take my line of thought here as line's out in the game.
And they've spread it out, empty backfield. First and goal at the one. Fade pass incomplete. With 6'4", Cortland Sutton trying to go to him on the back of the end zone again.
Good coverage this time.
Michael Downing.
Yeah, Michael Downing didn't start tonight, but obviously playing a lot. Now they got Prescott line back on the field.
An inside run by line a moment ago, converted on fourth down and about half a yard.
The Hogs inside digging in, trying to not get pushed into this end zone inside.
Second and goal. And it's thrown over the middle, and the catch is made. Touchdown, Cortland Sutton pulls this one in.
Wow. Fourth touchdown catch for Cortland Sutton in three games now. And that was good coverage, but the throw and the catch beat the coverage by Nick Orr.
How about that freshman from Brenham, Texas, Brian? As you said, fourth touchdown reception.
I tell you. I like the way Chad Moore's got aggressive and tried to get points here before the half.
And he got six and seven with the Chad Hedlund extra points. And SMU closes the gap. 28-17, they ended that stretch where TCU had scored 21 consecutive points.
Look at Cortland Sutton here on Nick Orr. He gives him the inside too easily. I just think that you can't allow him that kind of a release, especially with nobody else in the middle of the field. And great hands. You're going to hear a lot from Cortland Sutton. Nice fingertips there. Nice touch by Matt Davis. Oh, that's a good connection. Huh? Four touchdown catches already in 2.5 games.
Big 6'4", 215-pound receiver, able to get the defender sealed on the backside. And nice catch.
They said he's even a better kid, though. You know, sweet kid, wants to work hard, does everything right. You know, we talked to Chad Morris. He's coached these receivers. They're now in the NFL. DeAndre Hopkins, you know, Martavis Bryant. He made a connection to Martavis Bryant, the Pittsburgh Steeler last year for Clemson. He caught 8 touchdown passes. He said he could be in that category. You know, if he just keeps growing.
That's the second time I've heard this year you refer to someone as a sweet kid. Carl Joseph at West Virginia.
Well, he's a sweet kid off the field. On the field.
Inside the lines, different deal.
Yeah, no, he's different inside that. Some safety at West Virginia.
Nice answer back drive for SMU. The score going into the half, and now it's the squib kick and tight end Buck Jones up and fields it and races out to the 43-yard line.
Now with 4 seconds to go and Trevon Boykin in the Heisman hunt, a heck of a first half. Well, I guess they're gonna. There's 4 seconds on the clock, so guys are going into this going a little early. If I was Doug Meacham and I had Colby listen to me, world-class speed on the outside, I'd cut one loose, see what you can do.
59 yards away from the end zone with 4 seconds left in the half.
Here's Listenby down here. Got a little cloud coverage over the top on him, but I'd still give it a shot.
Up the gut, Aaron Green. Gets a block from Josh Dotson. Look at this. Green forced out of bounds. And that should end the first half, or is there a marker down here?
Well, there's a flag.
And the half can't end if there's a defensive penalty.
That's correct.
Holding, offense number 9. Penalty is declined. That's the end of the second quarter.
Well, that was Dotson, the receiver on the edge. We commented during the run that he was throwing a block, and the block was a hold, and so that ends the first half. TCU will have the ball to start the second half. Gary Patterson always does this. It isn't unique to tonight's game. Gathers the team around him on the field and says something before they go into the locker room.
I think he just wants to get their attention. You know, one last piece of advice before they go in, they kind of break up into their offensive group, their defensive groups. Kind of give him a quick survey of what he just saw.
This is the 95th matchup between SMU and TCU. TCU leads the series with 47 wins to 40 for SMU. 7 ties, 13 of the last 15 matchups in the battle for the Iron Skillet have gone TCU's way, but SMU plays them tough here, and they're playing them tough tonight. Gary Patterson instructs the troops to head to the locker room, and Gary Patterson is with Leslie McCaslin now down on the field. Leslie.
Thanks, guys. Well, Coach, so many moving pieces on defense with all the injuries. What more do you want to see them do in the second half?
Well, number one, we got to get stops. And the key is just winning. Looks like Latham and Ranthony are both out. So the key for us is we the next corner got to step up, the next end's got to step up, and we got to get ready to play.
What'd you like, though, about Trevon Boykin and your offense over 300 yards in the first half?
Oh, yeah, I mean, the key is, you know, it's probably the rest of the season, this is going to be what it's like. So get ready to play, and we got to get our stops when we do. You know, they're doing some nice things on offense. We got to tackle better, and we got to play the deep ball better.
All right, thanks, Coach.
You bet.
363 yards of offense is what TCU has. But he said it may be this way all year. They've given up 273 yards to SMU. Trevon Boykin has looked sensational tonight. Matt Davis trying to match him. Third-ranked TCU, 28-17 halftime lead over SMU. Stay with us on Fox College Football. The battle for the Iron Skillet tonight in Fort Worth at Amon Carter Stadium. Third-ranked TCU facing SMU in the 95th matchup between these two schools separated by 40 miles. Fox College Football, thanks for joining us tonight with Brian Baldinger. I'm Mark Falwell. You know, Brian is a pop music kind of guy. Yeah. I know you like that song, All About the Bass.
Yes.
All About the Offense is what it's been tonight for TCU and SMU through 30 minutes.
The Iron Skillet's hot, you know, and there's some big plays. It's been an exciting night of football here in Fort Worth at the campus of TCU, and really the big play players have shown up. Trevon Boykin has come out here, and he's been an electrifying player, much like he thought. It really, when you look at the highlights right now, it starts with the quarterback right here who leads this offense. I mean, this one right here to Turpin, up the middle, 61 yards, touchdown. He cuts this one loose to his favorite receiver, Josh Doxson, who's having a huge night. Touchdown throw here as he gets behind the defense. And then on the perimeter, I mean, he's going to challenge it. 50 yards of rushing in the first half. Gets out of that lasso and cuts that ball down, takes the distance for a touchdown. 21 unanswered points in the second quarter, but Matt Davis was almost as equally as exciting. They try to keep him in the pocket. He didn't want any part of it. He's got some sweet feet. He knows how to use them. Extends the plays. Keep him alive right here. They can't get a handle on him. Then he breaks out of the pocket. Extends this play on the outside. And throws this pass to Cortland Sutton right at the end of the first half. His fourth touchdown catch of the season. And you can see Matt Davis exhorting his team at the end of the second quarter.
The Ego Blowers' first half stats, 560 yards of offense in the game tonight. First downs, SMU has the advantage. Rushing yards, SMU has the slight advantage. TCU has thrown for almost 100 more yards than SMU. 12 yards per play for TCU. And both teams have really hurt themselves with penalties in this game, either sustaining drives or short-circuiting drives.
Yeah.
Trevon Boykin, 242 yards. As you look at the TCU offense here, Baldy, 75 yards on the ground for Aaron Green. That's a nice first half. He's really a footnote with the way the other players are performing on offense. Josh Doxson has been sensational. Three grabs, averaging 40 yards a pop. Has scored once, almost scored on another play in the first half.
Well, you know, they put up 28 points, 21 of them unanswered in the second quarter. And when you look at it, Matt Davis has been doing a good job of playing keep away. That SMU offense in the first half had 48 plays in 20 minutes of time of possession. So TCU's been taking advantage of it. Big plays, big scores. But I think Matt Davis feels pretty good. I think he's getting loose. I think he's enjoying this role. He's come a long ways from Texas A&M to Tyler Junior College to here. This man, Cortland Sutton, is a burgeoning star. I'm sure they'll hear all about him this year in the American Conference. Touchdown catch in the third straight game for him, four already on the season.
Last season in a game, SMU averaged 11 points and 270 yards. First half, 17 points tonight against TCU. And almost 270 yards of offense. Kickoff by Chad Hedlund. Devontae Turpin is running this out of the end zone. He was 2 yards deep, and he is showing off that slipperiness, is the term that you used earlier tonight, Brian, as he returns the ball outside the 20. Here's Leslie McCaslin.
Well, guys, I talked to SMU head coach Chad Morris at halftime about those penalties in the first half. He said, yeah, on those last four drives, he said, we scored a touchdown, and then we had three offensive penalties that just killed our drives. We were getting in to their end zone. We were able to get down the field, but it was just killing us. He said, we got to clean that up. He said, right now, guys, we are in a fist fight. He said, I love it. You have got to love these moments.
4-for-4 to start the game on third down conversions. SMU missed out on their last six third down attempts. And penalties were certainly a part of that. Aaron Green bouncing it outside. His drive is starting at the 24. And Richardson forces him out of bounds, so did Jonathan Yinga. There's the drive charge for TCU. Just one punt in the first half. There was a turnover on downs on the fourth and goal to the one-yard line.
That was a nice goal line stand by SMU to stay in the game and keep it close.
Eight-yard run for Aaron Green to start out the second half. Transfer from Nebraska. They give the ball to Green again, and a gaping hole on the right side. And Green went down to the 44.
You know, at halftime, people always talk about adjustments in college football. You have 20 minutes, and so Doug Meacham said, you know what? We don't have to get fancy against this defense. How about if we possess the ball a little bit, we get our running game going? Two runs here to Aaron Green, and, you know, they gained 25 yards.
Green up to 95 yards on the ground and has done that in only eight carries. Two crisp-looking running plays to start the third quarter. How about number three? SMU able to jam things up in the interior of the line. However, with second effort, Green fights forward to the 49. Justin Lawler getting up off the bottom of the pile defensively, but still a five-yard pickup.
And those guys up front, you know, starting with Big V at left tackle and Knapp and Hunt, bolts that group that don't get talked about a lot. They love it when they run Aaron Green like this because it just feels good just getting after the defensive line and getting some double teams at the point. Being able to run block a little bit.
Joey Hunt at center, 28 starts going into tonight.
That group up front tonight, 88 starts combined between the five starters.
Polakuli, Vati, Vitae, Big V, 22 starts at tackle. Here's Colby Listenby. Listenby going across the field. Can't unleash that 10.03 100-meter speed completely. Finally chased down by Jesse Montgomery after a pitch and catch for 20 yards.
Just once in my life, I'd like to see what it feels like to run a 10-flat 100 meters. I just want to feel the wind going by my ear.
From the 31, and he's going to Listenby again on the deep ball, and it's caught for a touchdown. Boykin to Listenby, 31 yards.
He's a whole lot more than just a track star. He's evolving into a heck of a receiver, and that catch should be bumped right to his resume reel. Gets up hobbling a little bit, but he went high in the air, turned his body, adjusted to it, and took it right away from the defender. It doesn't take long.
High play, 76-yard drive, and it didn't even take 2 minutes, Brian. 1:52. Overcrone makes it 35-17.
Elizabeth is really hurt. He came down awkward.
Now the last thing, again, TCU needs is more injuries. Now, the vast majority of those have been on the defensive side of the ball, but you've got such a great target here in Elizabeth. Hate to see him getting up limping, but he does haul that in from 31 yards out. Boykin with the strike. The lead opens up to 18 points for the Frogs. Second biggest scoring game ever, 70 points against the Lumberjacks. Halfway there tonight, early in the third quarter, Trevon Boykin with another touchdown pass. First two times that Colby Listenby has caught the ball tonight, those are the last 51 yards covered on the drive from Boykin and the TCU offense.
That's not a good sign there. Their burner on the outside getting worked on. Looks like he's on his back. He fell right on it, adjusting to the ball. Couldn't break the ball.
Overcrone kicks off. This will start at the 25. Let's look at SMU's first half drive charts. Touchdown and a field goal to start the game. Penalties, they were their own worst enemy on those drives where you see them coming up short, three punts and a turnover on downs, but they got it together for a quick drive at the end of the half.
And it was an important drive, too, because it kept them in the game, gives them some momentum, some confidence to go into the locker room at halftime. I don't think they have to get far away from the idea that they wanted to run the ball and control the clock. They did that in the first half with 48 plays and 20 minutes of time of possession.
Handing the ball off. Matt Davis gives it to Braden West. Twisting and thrown forward past the 30. Last week, SMU with 31 points against North Texas ended a 16-game streak of not reaching at least 30 points in a game. They're at 17, a nice-looking first down.
Taking a long time for them to win up on the hilltop, too. Quite a few days. Tad Morris, remember, 650-plus days before they'd won a home game.
Their only win last year on the road against Connecticut. Big hit in the middle.
That's Kendrick.
Yeah, Kendrick delivered the hit to Braden West.
That's Peanut. Just hitting West, the freshman, senior hitting the freshman right there. Form tackle, head up, right into his chest. Look at this technique right there. Stood him right up, feet just stop from Braden West. And he gets a whole bunch of purple jerseys to the party.
And the power of that hit stopped West a yard short of the first down.
Low man wins. It's all about leverage. Yep. You got running underneath West.
Big tackle by Kendrick, forcing SMU into a third down. They have missed out on their last six third down tries. How about number seven? Buried in the backfield, Traven Howard swallows up Matt Davis. And don't forget about Aaron Curry. He was back there as well.
Yeah, well, Traven Howard was there first. They converted safety right at the line of scrimmage. And Matt Davis doesn't look real sure about what he wants to do. And Howard was right where he's supposed to be, in that C gap. Matt Davis bounced out. He was there to stop
him. Ryan said converted safety, moving into a middle linebacker role after nine tackles, three tackles for loss last week against Stephen F. Austin. Nice work by the sophomore from Longview. A quick three and out. Words that SMU does not want to hear. The punt bounces out at the 31. 39 yards on the boot by Josh Williams. Traven Howard stuffed that third down attempt by Matt Davis at SMU. TCU has the ball back because of it. It's coming up 4 minutes deep into the quarter. Gary Patterson took over as TCU was transitioning from the WAC to Conference USA. They won two-thirds of their games at Conference USA. Then they really sprang to life in the Mountain West, 77-13, capped by winning the Rose Bowl in 2011. The first couple of years of the Big 12, they were finding their footing. But last year, TCU on the national scene competed for a spot in the first college football playoff. They ended up third in the nation after missing out on the playoff by two spots. Baylor finished fifth, TCU sixth, as the Big 12 did not get a team in the playoff. But they may have one in there this year, they're hoping, as TCU started the year second. Now they're third. And this drive starts with a nice pass dropped into the hands down to the 31-yard line. Great grab by Sean Nixon.
Little play action fake that time. Boykin turning his back to the defense, allowing Nixon to cross the field. Nixon getting involved. You see him at tailback. You see him in the slot. 3-by-1 set right now.
That's eight passes that he's caught this year as Green looks to take this to the outside and gets hammered at the 30-yard line.
Good hit that time to shut that down. SMU needs to stop. Remember Gary Patterson talking to Leslie right before the half began, saying we need to get stops. That's what SMU needs right now. They can't let this get away from them on this drive.
Remember TCU's season ended last year with a win over Ole Miss in the Peach Bowl. They ended the year third. Tonight is the 23rd game they played under Gary Patterson as a top five ranked team. A quick throw to Jarrison Stewart, by the way, Brian, just his second catch of the year.
What's his record?
21-1.
And what'd he say?
He said that tells me that I should have more games.
Yeah.
As a top five team. Only 22 is not enough. They went four receivers left. Aaron Green out of the backfield was lined up there, Brian, and caught the pass and maneuvered inside the 20-yard line before Anthony Roan dropped him.
The formations that they can throw at you, it is very difficult when they want to go at that high tempo, that high octane, to really sit there and kind of match up with them. Now they come to a power set, kind of an inverted wishbone here. Two tight ends in the backfield along with the tailback.
Boykin, listen to these numbers, 14-19 tonight, 341 yards in the air. Picture of efficiency. Dropping the throw, looking for the end zone. Oh, they found him over the middle. Dominique Murka, the tight end.
The offensive line just sprinted to party and celebrate with Murka. His first touchdown catch of the season. And they just used that formation to lull you to sleep that they're going to run the football and slip them out of the backfield. Fourth touchdown throw of the night for Boykin.
Every once in a while, the tight end gets involved in the passing game here. Buck Jones and Dominic Mirka are the tight ends listed on the two deep end. Number 84, Mirka pulls that one in, and TCU extends the lead on the Overchrome extra point to 42-17. Four touchdowns tonight, Ryan.
Yeah, and this one is pretty as any of them. DeMarco wide open. All he had to do was just wrap it up.
Clubs help young people to reach their full potential as productive, caring, and responsible citizens through programs that promote character and leadership, education, healthy lifestyles, and more. For more information, visit boxsportsupports.com. SMU took a timeout. 23-yard line. 8:20 left in the third quarter. TCU scored twice here in this third. And the pitch to Xavier Jones, and he can't cut inside Denzel Johnson, who dropped him for a loss.
Well, you know, that play was reviewed in the film study over and over. This fly sweep right now to Xavier Jones. And you could see that Denzel Johnson is just waiting on him. There's nobody there to block him. He saw it coming. I'm sure it was, you know, the review of the walkthroughs and the film study. They were ready for that play.
And with the tackle for loss, by virtue of being ready for it, now SMU looks at a second down and 12 against the TCU defense. Davis hit as he threw the ball, throws it up for grabs, and broken up in the end zone.
I threw a whole lot of purple jerseys here. Matt Davis just throwing that off his back foot, trying to get as much mustard on it as he can as he goes against Nick Orr here. Sutton, who's got four touchdown catches on the season. I don't know, that handle of the shoulder sometimes can throw a flag as you restrict Sutton from going up to get that ball.
Yeah, that's what happened, much to the chagrin of some watching the Cowboy-Giants game the other night. The hand on the shoulder, pass interference call.
No question. They couldn't find it on the replay.
Third down and 12. 7:42 left in the third quarter. Davis throwing again. Oh, what a turnaround catch! And Jeremiah Gaines has grabbed it and has stopped just short of the goal line.
What an adjustment by Gaines, a converted tight end. Catching only his third catch of the season. Matt Davis takes a shot. Watch. Wow. Downey has no idea where the ball is. And then the effort. Oh, he didn't control that all the way through, did he? Looks like that ball came out.
It will be reviewed.
As the runner was short of the goal line. Previous play is under further review.
'Sounds to me as if what, based on the referee Adam Savoy's explanation, is that they're reviewing whether or not this is a touchdown, not whether
right.
or not it's a catch.
Yeah, because that knee is down. Knee was down before the ball hit the ground. You see his couple good shots here. This left knee is down there. That ball should be like just outside the 1 yard line. And Matt Davis took his worst shot of the night, low right here. Boy, that could be a dangerous play as he kind of wiggled out of that.
Freshman Tipta Galliai from Trinity High School in Euless.
Of course, Jeremy Gaines wears number 23 in honor of Jerry Levias.
Yes.
First African-American player to play in the Southwest Conference. Every year somebody gets that jersey, number 23, and you've got to have character and be of the most upstanding
type
citizen. After review,
it has been determined that the ball carrier was down at the yard and a half yard line. First and goal.
That's the right spot. Chad Moore staying aggressive here. Trying to stay on the heels of Gary Patterson's TCU team that just continues to explode offensively.
Javon Boykin's thrown for four touchdowns tonight. Matt Davis, the junior quarterback for SMU. He's thrown for a touchdown tonight, found Cortland Sutton at the end of the first half from about this spot on the field. We've got Prescott Line in the backfield. As you heard the referee say, it's at the 1.5, and the exchange is fumbled, and Davis jumps and falls on it at the 4.
Now you can't have that kind of exchange problem between him and Prescott Line here in this situation. He's either giving it to him or taking it away. It looks like he wanted to take it away. And Line wanted the ball. I can't tell which one thought he was going to get it.
thought he was giving it to Lyon. Lyon didn't want it. The result is they lose over 2 yards on that fumble.
Back to the four. Davis keeps it this time. Pretty spin move. Fights his way into the end zone. Touchdown, SMU. They are not ready to go quietly into the night, Brian.
Not at all, Mark. What an effort by Matt Davis. He was stopped behind the line of scrimmage on the option. Then he spun out of a tackle to stay on his feet. And he just continues to impress. Hard to believe this is only his eighth start, you know, for the SMU.
Five games last year, including the only win of the season against Connecticut. Three games to start this season. They hung with Baylor into the second half before losing 56-21, beat North Texas last week. And they score a badly needed touchdown here, getting back to under 20 points on the scoreboard deficit-wise. 42-24 after Matt Davis on second and goal runs this in from 4 yards out.
Kipa's got him a chance right there. He breaks a tackle. Kindred, who has about 9 tackles tonight, breaks right out of the brace here of Derek Kindred, who's probably their best tackler. And that's what you get from Chad Morris. You get a little pat on the helmet. And look at that frown.
Man, that's a scowl.
That's a scowl. He can't believe that his best tackler, you know, had that man just break.
And the offensive line and the rest of the offense. You saw Xavier Jones sitting there as well with a high five with Matt Davis. For Matt Davis, that touchdown run is the third time that he's found the end zone with his feet this season. Has a touchdown pass tonight. That gives Davis 5 touchdown passes for the year.
He's run for well over 100 yards in each of the first 2 games. He's moving up the charts here tonight at about 50 at the half.
Loss of yardage due to sacks. He sits at 42 right now on 12 carries. Remember, there was a sack earlier in the half. There was a play that was lost yardage when he tried to keep it on a third down. They lost yardage when Davis had to fall on it in the fumble situation. Yeah. So the numbers don't look quite as good, but that particular snapshot certainly looks good with Davis running the ball in.
Trevon Boykin hidden behind all of the behemoths in front of him. I think all he wants to do is, all right, let's go, boys. Let's go score again. That's what we got to do.
Man, he spread it around, too. You know, you said earlier tonight something about Boykin being the point guard.
Yeah.
Here's how he's dishing out assists tonight. Yeah. He's completed 9 of his last 9 to 8 different receivers. The only player to catch multiple passes in this run is Colby Lissenby, who caught him back-to-back.
That's the only way to keep them all happy, I think.
Spread the wealth. Spread the love. Play fake. Slanina underneath. He catches, but barely reaches back to the line of scrimmage. Got taken out of a shoe by Kyron Mitchell. And second down to 10 and a half. Coming up. Boykin throws. Ooh. Oh, picked off! Picked off at the 45-yard line. Horace Richardson going all the way across the field. Gets a nice block from David Johnson. How about that return to the 25? A run of 10 straight completions ends for Boykin in an interception for Horace Richardson, a junior from Everman right here in Tarrant County.
Well, he's the boundary corner, and he's throwing into the boundary here. This is a bad throw. I mean, here's Richardson down at the bottom. You're going to have just a little switch route. So Richardson can't believe it. He's got help over the top so he can sit underneath. So good defense that time by Van Malone to create the first takeaway of the game. Richardson doing his best to stay alive and to get as many yards, and now SMU with the best field position of the night. They have a chance to cut this lead a little closer here, and the only mistake of the night by Boykin.
First turnover. First turnover for either team. Dropping the throw, Davis, and they go back shoulder, and he caught it and pushed out right around the 5-yard line. How about Braden West?
Well, they had both backs in the back in the play that time. Both Jones and West. West at wide receiver. Nice job of adjusting. So you've got both feet in bounds.
Yeah.
I mean, we're seeing some athletic ability from these receivers adjusting to Matt Davis's throws, and he's throwing them open.
19 yards. Now Xavier Jones, and he nice right up the middle. Is he in? Just short.
Well, what a burst that time by Jones. We see West making a great catch. We see Jones bursting one right up the middle. A couple of freshmen there that they're excited about, and you can see why.
Now second and goal inside the one. Davis, quarterback sneak behind the right side of the line. Stretches forward. Touchdown, SMU. They convert off the turnover.
I think this rivalry is getting a lot more fun with Chad Morris at the helm at SMU.
Well, and they had a sense of urgency after that turnover, Brian. Boom, boom, boom. Three plays. The pass to West, the run by Jones, the quarterback sneak behind the line by Davis, and into the end zone they go.
Joe Craddock said, they're coming here, the offensive coordinator of SMU, we're coming here to win the game. You know, we don't care what their rank or what their stats are. We're coming to win.
Young offensive coordinator Joe Craddock, who had been a GA at Clemson under Chad Morris. Now he's the offensive coordinator, dialed up a couple of nice plays, but first it was Van Malone's defense.
5-yard penalty, replay the try.
We're going to have to redo the extra point, by the way, but there was the Horace Richardson interception, Baldy.
Yeah, I mean, Horace Richardson now, I mean, great defense that time, called by Van Malone. Helped over the top, allowed Richardson to play underneath, and Boykin. All right, so here's the second touchdown run, back-to-back touchdown runs for Matt Davis. Cut this lead. We'll try this extra point try one more time.
Procedure penalty, moved it back 5 yards, but no problem for Chad Hedlund. He's made all of his extra points so far this year, 11 of 11 in three games for the...
Is there another flag?
Yep. There is. What is it?
Offside. Defense. Penalty is declined. Try is good.
A pretty important, interesting swing. 42-31 is the score. For the second straight week, SMU has put 31 points on the board. They did it in a winning effort last week, Brian. 31-13 over North Texas. And Chad Morris wanted them to savor the flavor of a victory. Look at that postgame celebration last week in the SMU locker room.
Well, he got the party started. First win at SMU. And I'm telling you, if they make some sort of miracle comeback and win this game, I don't know how y'all do that.
No.
Because I don't know how many more moves Chad has in him.
We got a chance to talk to him tonight on the field before the game. Now, he was downplaying his dancing.
Yeah.
But he was not downplaying how good he felt about how his team is playing. And he said, look, if we're there in the fourth quarter, then we're going to be ready to go. We're gonna bring everything we have in those guys.
Well, his enthusiasm is infectious, and it's in every meeting, it's in every practice, it's every day. And look, over 1,000 coaches came to visit in spring practice this year between March 17th and April 18th. 1,000 high school coaches from the state of Texas came to watch that man coach.
And he wants to recruit Texas, 22 of 22 on signing day 2015. Special teams carries that momentum over. Down goes Kevonte Turpin. That's the most pedestrian they've made him look on a return tonight, says Kevin Johnson made the tackle. SMU's offense, I mean, look at the jumps that they have made from their abysmal place offensively last year.
Well, it's a totally different team. You can just see it. I mean, right now their confidence is growing as a team in this game. They just had back-to-back scores. They got a takeaway from one of the best offenses, one of the best quarterbacks in the country. We'll see how Trevon answers that interception.
On the 23, after the return by Turpin, turning and handing the ball off, Green running it. You know, I thought what was interesting about what Chad Morris told us this week, two things. Number one, he said, our footprint is the state of Texas. The heel of that footprint is DFW in East Texas. And he said, when I was a high school coach, it was an insult to me if you had to fly over or drive past Texas to go get a player and didn't keep somebody here.
That's right.
Second down and 5 after the run by Green. Play fake underneath Desmond White, his first catch, and runs out of a tackle, but then Darian Richardson blasts him at the 35. picked up a couple of more yards after contact, Baldy.
Is there anybody that catches the ball for TCU that doesn't look quick and doesn't look fast? And all look like they can do that.
And Brian, as much as they've spread it around tonight, that's the first time Desmond White's caught the ball. He had a drop earlier in the game, but that's his first catch. And the 37. SMU has the last 14 points in the game. TCU, the first down. Marker is down for something on the edge that occurred as Boykin was bouncing and maneuvering to the outside. Gain 6, but let's see what happens.
This is coming back.
Holding, offense number 74, 10-yard penalty, first down.
It's Big V at left tackle. We have mentioned his name in a good light. One of the more massive people on the planet. There he is, just trying to seal the edge against Zach Wood. And his hands were outside the jerseys. You put this TCU offensive line up physically against the Dallas Cowboys offensive line, there wouldn't be any difference. They're just as big, just as heavy, not as talented, not as skilled yet, but big.
Polapulivati Vaitai is 6'6", 315, but the offensive line couldn't hold back SMU's defense, and Boykin throws the ball into the turf.
Well, all the offensive line was down the field trying to lead a middle screen here. They've all released, so it's a free run that time by Lawler. And that's a good. He let up on that. There shouldn't be any flag for that.
Sophomore defensive lineman, Pottsboro, Texas, up by Lake Texoma. He has a sack tonight. Holding penalty, pushed TCU back. Now they look at second and 20. Boykin whips it. Caught by Stewart. We're seeing Jarrison Stewart get into the act tonight from Mesquite Horn High School with a couple of catches. There's another marker down. So hold the phone.
Holding. Offense, number 9. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
That's Josh Dotson.
This is just really unusual for a Gary Patterson team to have this many penalties and them beating themselves like this. The turnover, the penalties, constantly putting themselves in a negative situation. I'm sure that will be addressed before anybody gets dressed tonight.
And the penalties, Brian, are big penalties.
Yeah.
We're talking about holding 10 yards, pass interference 15 yards, personal foul 15 yards.
And it's taking the rhythm away as well.
Spot foul, so it's second and 16. And in pressure, Boykin goes down. Finally, that pocket collapsed. It looked like he was going to slither out of there a couple of times, but Robert Seal sacks Boykin.
Yeah, and they just kept him in the pocket. They didn't let him get out. You see, just a four-man rush. There's no blitzing here. Just relentless, good coverage, seven men covering down the field. Then they collapse on him as he tries to break the pocket. Another sack up front. Seals gets there first.
Seals' fourth career sack. Now third and 22. Boykin heaves it and batted down. Leaping up the safety, Jordan Wyatt with a blocked shot, swatting it away.
Got a flag down.
Third and 22, TCU.
This is against TCU. SMU would just decline it.
That might be what the referee is confirming as we speak.
Personal foul. Hands to the face. Offense number 77. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Well, that's not the confident look of Trevon Boykin. Jamel Knapp, the left guard here in the middle. You got the Lawler coming in, and there's the hands to Lawler's face that they flag, but this ball was almost intercepted. Well, it's a little too high for Jordan Wyatt.
Yeah, it didn't swat it away quite as much as I thought initially. Here's the punt by Ethan Perry. Oh, fumbled, picked up by Braden West. Ran out of one tackle. Oh, ran out of a couple more. Braden West up to the 40. I'd say we've had a full-fledged swing in the pendulum of momentum. We'll talk about that after Ginny Taft has this Fox College football game break.
Well, Mark, thanks. An upset alert in Tuscaloosa after number 2 Alabama fumbled a kickoff for the second time tonight. Rebels quarterback Chad Kelly punches it in for the score. 15th-ranked Ole Miss up 17-3 in the second. Mark Bryant, back to you.
Ole Miss won last year in Oxford over Alabama. I don't know that we're on upset alert just yet here, but like I said a minute ago, Brian, we've had certainly a big change in the pendulum of momentum right here.
14 straight points for SMU. Answer the 14 straight that TCU scored to start the third quarter.
And then a messy drive by TCU full of penalties. Here's Davis. The long ball for Sutton. He adjusts to it and does it again. And they still can't bring him down. Finally do Corey O'Mealy, but not before Sutton dragged him down inside the 15.
And Derek Kindred is right there coming across the middle from a safety position. Completely missed the ball there. But Sutton is just having an unbelievable dream. O'Mealy's all over him. He's grabbing him, he's pulling him, and all he does is concentrate on the ball, make another great catch.
46 yards on that catch. At the 14, Davis hands the ball to Xavier Jones. Ran into the back of his offensive line and then couldn't fight out of an ankle tackle. 2-yard gain.
Can Matt Davis do anything more tonight? I mean, it's just one big play after another. You talk about a confident kid and growing. Look at that look on TCU's face. That's not the look that they're used to having late third quarters at home here. Especially after beating SMU a year ago, 56-0.
Cortland Sutton now, 3 catches, 72 yards. Has a touchdown tonight. 2nd and 8. Davis keeping it. Looking for room inside, and he found it. Inside the 5, and he won't go down. Finally wrestled to the turf by Josh Caraway, Derek Kindred, and others around the 4.
No, Matt Davis is 6 foot. He's listed at 212 pounds. I don't know that he's even 6 foot, Mark. We saw him down the field, said hello to him before the game. But what they said, just competitive fire in him. And you can see it right now. Just coming out. It's not going down easy. It's every fight for every blade of grass on this field.
Third down and 1. Prescott line right into the middle of the line. There wasn't much of a push.
No. They stacked it and stuffed it pretty good right there, but you have to go for it. They didn't go for a 4th and 1 in the first quarter. They settled for a field goal. Good penetration that time. Henderson back in the game. He got his arms around line. I don't know if this is the right move. With Matt Davis on the field, anything is possible. I'd stay aggressive. I know you could cut this lead to 1 score here, to an 8-point game, but
you're going to have to hurry. Yeah. The play clock is down to 2 seconds. And a tough angle field goal is good from 21 yards out. And he did opt to make it a 1-possession game. Chad Morris and SMU field goal on the final play of the third quarter. Good for Chad Hedlund. We got a game going to the 4th. The Frogs up by 8. For 3rd-ranked TCU leading SMU 42-34. 950 yards of offense tonight. SMU has scored 17 straight points after they were down 42-17. Monte Turpin has 105 yards in kickoff returns tonight, but he will not take this one out of the end zone. Good kick by Chad Hedlund. 25-yard line is where TCU will start the 4th quarter. SMU just booted through a 21-yard field goal by Hedlund to end the 3rd quarter. And here comes Trevon Boykin and the TCU offense all of a sudden in a little bit of a rut here, Brian.
A little bit of a rut, and you can see Trevon Boykin. Just so let's go. Let's get this. Let's start answering some of these scores. Let's put it together, and that's what you got to do as a leader. You know, get the kids confident, get the guys around you believing that you're going to go down here and, you know, answer what SMU has done, which is 17 straight points.
Aaron Green runs the ball. Nice hole. 35, cuts to the 40. Gain of 16 on that run by Aaron Green. And here's how things have gone since TCU went up 42-17. SMU drove and scored a touchdown. Then an interception set him up for a touchdown. And a field goal a moment ago, but another quick hitter on the run up-tempo offense here. Green runs for 8 yards.
Well, really, SMU can't stop the offense. I mean, TCU's beaten themselves with the turnover and with a lot of penalties. They've been their own biggest enemy here, and if they can stop that, they can certainly put another drive together. Green's averaging 10 yards a carry.
Green getting a breather now. Sidearm pass to Dotson. Caught it at midfield on second and short. And converts the first down before Ajay Montez bumps him out.
He go full sidearm on that one. Didn't fall off the mound, though.
Kyle Hicks is in the game in the backfield. And Hicks gets to run this. Gains 5 on first down. 10 carries this year coming into tonight's game. That's his first one tonight.
Tight end coming in the game, Dominic Mirka, catching his first pass and first touchdown catch as a blocking tight end.
Your first catch in college as a senior, Dominic Mirka, earlier tonight. That was the last TCU touchdown. One base drive here, tough running. Hicks stays after it. Whites down near the first down, very close to the 34 of SMU.
And that was the lead block by Mirka. Going to allow that first down to get to take place.
I think it might be just a little bit short here.
Oh, yeah, we are just a
skosh.
A skosh.
Third down and a half yard, if that. Mirka is the blocking back. Green's back into the game, and they do have it. Yep. No doubt about it. Green surges down to the 32.
And Green gets up all pumped up. Let's go.
Well, this thing has gotten too close for comfort.
Well, that's what you do when you're too close for comfort. You do something about it.
Green belted. The hole closed down that time. And Caleb Tuiasosopo delivered a lick.
I knew you were going to get that gate and that name out clean.
Yes, sir.
Tuiasosopo, what a great name in NFL history.
Ryan's drive, 7 plays for TCU, 6 of them have been runs. And the pass was just a little quick wing it out on the side to Dotson a minute ago. That sidearm pass. Single down and 9. Oh! Josh Dotson incomplete.
I didn't know he was capable of dropping one. Bounced right off his shoulder pad, knocked his mouth piece right out of his mouth. Just a quick slant here. You never saw it, right off the face mask. Wouldn't expect it.
Ooh.
Wow. I think there was a piece of glass there. Plexiglass kind of protected him.
Last year's second most catches in a season in TCU history. Didn't drop many. 65 grabs last year. Most yards in TCU history. Over 1,000. Third down. Boykin going to run. Got a downfield block. Has the first down and a whole lot more. A flag flies in late. Even if it's a foul for an illegal block, a hold of some sort, the spot foul should still leave them in a first down position. A conversion of a first down here, Baldy.
Holding, offense number 9, 10-yard penalty, third down.
Well, how many holding calls now for Docks? That's at least 2 on him on the outside.
And it's not a downfield spot foul situation.
Dotson coming back to block. That's a bad call. That's a bad call. His hands were inside. He wasn't grabbing. Just doing what wide receivers are supposed to do. He's actually blocking.
Third down and 4 now is what TCU is facing. They do get credit for 5 yards move forward there. Inside handoff. Hicks. The stretch has him pretty close. Dropped by Justin Lawler, number 99 for SMU. Can't believe this number, Brian. 100 yards in penalties tonight on TCU.
Yeah. Right now, Brady Bolts, the senior right guard, came out of the game. Matt Pryor went in there at right guard for him.
And it's 112 yards in penalties. And it's 4th down and 1 yard. Maybe 4th and inches as TCU goes for it. Green running the ball, Robert Seals hits him, and SMU with a big stand here. Let's see where the spot is.
It's SMU's ball.
Yes, it is. They hold on downs. Robert Seals.
Look at that celebration.
What a hit by Seals. They were ready for that play. Just kind of like the stretch to the right side. Yeah, he knows it. He knows it's SMU's ball. They did what they had to do. Look at this hit on Green. And he got the wrap. He hit him and he wrapped him. And now here comes the help. Here comes McClanahan in for the help.
Zach Wood.
Yeah.
Robert Seals has a sack tonight, and he has a tackle for loss on fourth down.
That's just pure, raw emotion from Robert Seals.
Well, SMU, you're supposed to make a wish at 11-11. And here's Matt Davis back to pass. They are one score away from potentially tying the game, and Davis has done it all tonight, legs and arm, and he is able to scramble up over the 40.
How'd he get away from two defenders that both had their hands on him and ran right through him? He must be awfully strong. Hey there for the American Conference. It'll be a big surprise in that conference with SMU this year.
18-yard run there for Matt Davis. SMU will start American Athletic Conference play in 2 weeks, by the way, against East Carolina. Drops. Cortland Sutton.
Well, that's a connection that you're going to hear a lot about. Matt Davis to Cortland Sutton. Sutton's looking a little tired right now in this fourth quarter. Who's got gas in the tank? I mean, who still has enough juice right now to finish this? I know Gary Patterson is, he's going to keep coaching, trying to get a stop. SMU hadn't been stopped much in the last three possessions.
Touchdown, touchdown, field goal. They were stopped on a third and one, and they settled for a short field goal at the end of the third quarter. Now 10:39 to go. Davis with time, and Davis is looking on the deep ball for Sutton, and another adjustment back to the ball. Markers down, he caught it at the 15.
It was better that the ball was underthrown. The only one looking back for it was Sutton, and he adjusted.
Pass interference, defense number 3. Penalty is declined. Result of the play is a first down.
Torrance Mosley with the penalty.
Yeah, well, that's he's just, look, he's in good position. Little out and up. Okay, he got behind him on that double move. And now the adjustment. One adjustment after another by Sutton all night. Wow.
4 catches, 115 yards. He also had a highlight reel catch negated because of a holding penalty earlier in the game. Here comes a blitz. Davis in trouble. Got away. No. Down he goes. Loss of 4. Bryson Henderson has had 2 penalties called against him tonight, but he makes dead dog sure on that play to wrap him up and bring him down.
Matt Davis felt him coming. He thought he could get away, and Henderson stayed with him. Lucky that he just kept that hand and that big paw right there on the jersey where he could get a little bit of a grip to pull him down.
Loss of 4 on the sack by Henderson. Sophomore defensive lineman from Mansfield. Davis from the 19. Under pressure again and swung out of bounds. This time it was Josh Caraway.
Both defensive ends now getting busy. Caraway and Henderson both playing.
And Brian, the TCU defense bowing up here after the big play to Sutton. Back-to-back sacks.
Yeah, backing SMU up here. But you cannot, as these fans are showing, you cannot rest and relax here just because it's 39 or third and long. Matt Davis is capable of anything. And they're playing big-time coverage as 10 yards off the ball, 7 defenders.
Timeout. Second
timeout.
One taken by SMU.
They're second.
9:07 to go. We have ourselves a game. Third-ranked TCU trying to hang on. Today. And by Ford, visit your local Texas Ford dealer. Ford is the best in Texas. TCU's been the best team in Texas over the last 10 years when you look at winning percentage. They're third ranked in the nation going into play tonight. But they surrendered 17 straight points. They've seen most of their lead evaporate. Now SMU down by 8 in the fourth quarter. 9 minutes to go. Has a 3rd and 17 at the TCU 22. Underneath throw, juggled, caught, but instantly down at the 15 is Braden West.
Well, that's if that throw, the idea there was seven dropped, you know, 10 yards off the ball. Thrown underneath, and maybe you can run for it, but the ball was thrown short. So that's all West could do. So a little bit closer here for Hedlund.
Chad Hedlund spent a season and a half as the kicker at Wake Forest. He went 11 of 15 on field goals in that time frame. His long was 51. He's 2 for 2 tonight, 3 for 3 on the year. This try is 32 yards. You see the angle. Derek Kirstich is the holder. Not pretty, but effective. It's a 5-point game with 8:20 remaining. Chad Morris's team bidding for a huge upset on the road.
It helps to have that guy. Patterson, can you get any closer to Trevon Boykin?
42-37, TCU. Stay with us for the last 8:20. Game at 1 point in the third quarter. But SMU, 4 straight drives have netted points, Baldy.
Well, that first one for 75 yards, that was after TCU scored. And then they had the interception, got the ball in good field position, 25 yards, scored 3 plays, and got 2 punts and scored after their stops. And so SMU trying to kick off here, get one more stop, maybe try to take the lead here.
Chad Hedlund, deep kick. Nothing to do for Kevontae Turpin to take a knee, 8 yards deep. So what do you do if you're TCU? You've seen the lead shrink from 25 to 5, 8:20 to go.
Well, it's all there. I mean, they just have to execute. You know, they've been their own worst enemy. Interception, a lot of penalties that put them in negative situations. I think the whole playbook works. The one guy they're missing right now is their speed with Colby Lissabe, who I don't believe has been back on the field since he caught a touchdown pass.
Yep. Caught the touchdown that made it 35-17 and has not been back on the field since. To clarify the penalties, by the way, for TCU tonight, it's 8 penalties, 100 yards in penalties. Play fake Boykin. Over the middle, Ty Slanina catches it. Gets popped by Darian Richardson and Jackson Mitchell. But big yardage on the first play of the drive, 22.
And that's a confident throw. Saying it all night. Boykin's advance and development, big part, has been able to throw the ball over the middle of the field, and that's a prime example of Slanina.
Under the 8-minute mark. SMU, by the way, only has 1 timeout left. Big hole for Aaron Green to run through. Dropped after a run of 8 by Shaquille Randolph.
Green's a weapon now. He stays low. That was a good cut. Good vision cut to his backside. On that run.
So many weapons on this TCU offense that has put together over 620 yards tonight. SMU offense, by the way, at 482 yards. Boykin keeping it. McClenahan ran up and wrapped him up, and Zach Wood helped.
I am impressed by the front four. I know 620 yards, they put up a lot of, but the front four of the Mustangs here, hurry up right now.
Keeping it, Boykin jammed up in the middle, will depend on the spot, which looks like the spot is going to give them a fresh set of downs, converting on third and short.
Situational football, Doug Meacham has them all rehearsed at third and a half a yard. Tough situation right there, spread the field, quarterback sneak. Hard to believe that Doug Meacham was an offensive lineman at one point. But sometimes linemen go one way and you get heavy, and sometimes they shrink and feel a whole lot better. The joints feel a lot better for the rest of their life.
I feel like you're speaking from experience.
A little bit.
TCU 5-9 on third downs after that conversion. Now Boykin is throwing for all of it. Oh, juggled and caught! What a grab! Josh Dobson!
He threw that. How did he adjust to that football? For a kid that went to Wyoming, transferred back, walked on, didn't have a scholarship 2 years ago, can make a catch like this as Boykin gets planted. Look at this adjustment to a ball. Sometimes you just want it. You just want it really bad.
Brian, Josh Dotson sat over in the sideline and seen what Cortland Sutton has done for SMU tonight in terms of adjusting to balls in flight.
Sure.
And Dotson does it there, pulls it in, 42 yards for Dotson's second touchdown tonight. Five catches, 171 yards for the senior from Mansfield.
It's all one-on-one football. How do you play the ball in the air?
Ain't over. 49-37. Big, badly needed touchdown right there, though, for the TCU Horned Frogs, ranked number three in the country.
Well, this is the type of plays you want from your two seniors. The quarterback, look at this adjustment to a ball.
Big, big drive for TCU. Ends in Josh Dotson's 42-yard touchdown grab. A juggling touchdown grab, I might add. Five plays, 75-yard drive, 18th career touchdown catch for Josh Dotson. One of the best to ever put on the uniform and play wide receiver here at TCU.
Well, he had 11 last year, breaking the record held by Jeremy Curley and my good friend Mike Renfro.
Going to be a touchback with 6:32 left, SMU down 12. Here's Leslie McCaslin.
Well, the SMU coaches like their quarterback, Matt Davis's mobility, but they want him to protect himself. So they brought a slip and slide out to practice last week and made him work on getting down. He said he's trying, but he told me if it's late in a game or a big down, he is going to be aggressive and get as many yards as he can for his team. Guys, he's done exactly that so far.
Well, he certainly has, and there's no protecting yourself now, down 12 with a chance to beat the third-ranked team in the country.
Nah, you let it all go now.
But it is a two-touchdown deficit that they can't get a field goal and a touchdown and a two-point conversion. As Xavier Jones running the ball is dropped by Montrell Wilson.
I thought when Chad Morris told us that he wanted to play time of possession and run the ball and play a different style, I didn't know that they were going to have this many big play capabilities in the arsenal.
Second down and five. Davis. Davis a deep ball. He wants Cortland Sutton again. Cool. Corey O'Mealy on the coverage, and the marker flies in.
Sutton picked up the flag. He's exhausted. He's run a lot of go routes tonight, trying to find a little air.
Defense
in this.
Number two, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Sutton trying to find a little air in this Texas humidity. There's one-on-one football. We've seen it all night. Look at this effort. Sticking out the left hand here, trying to make another circus one-handed catch. O'Mealy just trying to stay with them. Well, you have to take these deep shots in college football. You have to keep at it because you can get these the flags, you can get the interference calls.
And several interference calls tonight. Nine penalties against TCU, 115 yards. Out of the 45, here's heavy pressure.
Wow.
And he got rid of the ball, and it's complete.
He
found Denzel Johnson had the pressure, but Davis found Kevin Thomas, Brian.
As he was getting dragged to the ground. I mean, they got a blitz coming from the outside. Here comes Denzel Johnson. He's going to hit him as he throws. You see the ball wobble, but he finds Thomas on the outside for a good game.
Picked up seven. 5:45 to go. Cut down on the handoff. Xavier Jones only gained a yard. Denzel Johnson in again on a stop.
Well, it's third and about two. You know that SMU's in four down territory, so you've got to have two plays in the chamber in case Gary Patterson can stop them on this down.
SMU started the game 4-for-4 on third down. They have made only one of their last 10 attempts on third down. They need two, but they're going for a whole lot more than that. To the end zone, down goes Sutton again. There will be no marker flying in here.
I thought they dragged him down that time. I mean, here it is. Here's O'Mealy again.
I think feet just get tangled up.
Yeah. It was a little bit of an overthrow. They tried to get two guys, Nick Moore over there, trying to get two guys on Sutton. He just stumbled at the end. Those legs might be getting a little fatigued here.
Play clock right now is at 12 seconds. The last time out for SMU. They'll have to go the rest of the way without an ability to stop the clock. Down by 12, 5:05 to go. End of the game. Some sensational throws tonight. Here's Cortland Sutton for SMU, two of his five receptions tonight. Josh Dotson, five catches, 171 yards, two touchdowns. That's normally the Bass Pro Shops catch of the game, but it can't be one tonight.
They gotta start doing catches of the game. Too hard to choose just one.
Here's fourth and two for SMU. The TCU 47. Down 12, 5 minutes to go. Broken up!
Nick Orr
against Shelby Walker.
That's good defense. They got great defense when they needed it. Perfect position by Nick Orr, taking the inside away, undercutting him. Nick Orr has played all over the field tonight. He's got that left hand on the hip of Shelby Walker. Sometimes they don't let you turn the player like that, but no call that time.
5 minutes remaining. Nick Orr has started this year at corner. He slid back to weak safety to begin the game tonight.
Yep.
But they've had to move him back to corner, Brian. Ranthony Tejada suffered an injury tonight. Gary Patterson told the TCU radio broadcast, as a matter of fact, it may be a season-ending knee injury. Down goes Sean Nixon on the run after the turnover on downs.
Well, that's the stop that TCU needed. Now they'll try to milk the clock just a little bit with SMU with no timeouts remaining. Try to chew some of this up.
Sean Nixon as a redshirt freshman from Lake Travis High School. That's where Chad Morris won two state titles as a coach in 2008 and 2009.
Bet.
Nixon just ran the ball for 9 yards. We'll have another opportunity to run. He wants to stay in bounds and wisely cut it back towards the middle of the field. Spins and has a first down.
You know, Gary Patterson really has a division of labor. His offensive coordinators, both Meacham along with Cumbie. He says, those guys are in a country club. My defensive guys, we're in the rock quarry over here. We're just pounding rocks. But right now, he's telling Doug Meacham, look, you make sure you use the clock. You know, it's their enemy right now. Make sure you tick off as much as you can. You know, the Giants on Sunday night wish they would have used a little bit more clock against the Cowboys at the end of that game.
Two runs by Sean Nixon. Now Aaron Green, who's had a heck of a night, is back into the game. Bounces to the outside and slides down. He'll wind the clock. Take himself up inbounds.
Smart move by the senior Aaron Green to get down.
Came up a yard short of the first down, but running clock is of much more importance at this stage.
Right.
Green has 152 yards rushing tonight. And we said this earlier when we talked about his stats, that almost an afterthought with Boykin and Dotson and some of the things happening on offense for SMU. But he's delivered some big, big runs. Aaron Green has. He's found the end zone tonight as well. They use up almost all of the play clock. Bouncing to the outside. And another run here. Stumbling forward is Nixon. Nixon's had three nice runs on this clock-killing drive.
Yeah. A young player they affectionately just called Poe. Kind of a nickname that has stuck here. And nice piece of running as he gets congratulated. He gets down. Up for the first down, trying to chew some more clock here.
Sean Nixon has four runs tonight for 34 yards. Three of the carries have been on the drive here at the end. 708 yards, my goodness. Jeez. And SMU not too shabby, obviously, at 495. This one is Aaron Green. Picks up seven.
Well, TCU hasn't been able to relax much tonight because of the play of SMU, but right now this is how you finish a game. You give it to your offensive line, you give it to a bunch of backs, let them just chew up some yards here, chew up the clock. Boykin, jeez.
454 passing yards, tonight's Texas Farm Bureau Insurance Player of the Game.
That looked good as he
start adding up some Heisman Trophy stats.
Another handoff. This is Aaron Green. Converts the first down, stopped short of a touchdown by Jordan Wyatt and Jonathan Yenga. And now a minute and a half remaining. The gas went out of the tank for SMU on that fourth down. They couldn't convert, and TCU has burned up four of the final 5 minutes on this drive, and presumably will be able to just take the clock all the way down to the end of the game.
Now, there's no moral victories for Chad Morris, I'm sure, but he's got to be proud of how they competed tonight, how hard they played, and how explosive the offense was.
Green will run it into the end zone.
Eighth touchdown of the night for the Horned Frogs.
And they score the last two touchdowns after SMU's 20-point burst had pulled them to within five. But the offense answered the bell, an offense that has put over 700 yards on the board tonight and 56 points with 56 seconds remaining in the game.
And they needed it. They needed it on tonight. And really, Aaron Green here has had a tremendous evening. I mean, he doesn't look like he's fatigued at all throughout the night.
At 21 carries tonight, 164 yards.
They'll get him ready for a conference play here starting next week.
And that's in Lubbock next week. And Texas Tech defeated Arkansas tonight, 35-24 in Fayetteville.
Yeah.
Texas Tech was embarrassed by Arkansas last year. With
sure
what
was.
Arkansas did, I don't think they threw the ball at all in the second half of a blowout win out in Lubbock and a big bounce back by Texas Tech. And they're braced and ready to go for conference play against TCU next
week. 2-3-0 teams. We saw Texas Tech last weekend. Good young quarterback there. Just the way SMU does here with Matt Davis, the way he's performed.
Final minute of the game. Fielded at the goal line, a yard deep, down by Braden West. Next week, more Big 12 football with Fox College Football. Rice taking on the fifth-ranked Baylor Bears. Our coverage begins at 3 Eastern. College football on Fox Sports Networks. Baldy, you'll be down there in Waco.
Sure will. Beautiful stadium down there. Art Briles completely turned that program around, the way Gary Patterson turned this program around. I'm sure the way Chad Morris is going to turn that SMU program around.
Better days are certainly ahead for SMU. That may not be much of a consolation for them tonight, but they got up off the mat. They could have been knocked out of the third quarter at 42-17.
No question.
Scored 20 straight points and made TCU sweat to win this game tonight. The backup quarterback is in, Darryl Colbert. He's run the ball three times this year and thrown it once, and getting the mop-up duty here in the last minute of the game. SMU plays James Madison from FCS at home next week, a ranked FCS opponent, by the way. And then American Athletic Conference play starts for them the following week against East Carolina. But the story for TCU is they're about to be 3-0. Third-ranked team of the country had a battle tonight, but you know what? The number one-ranked team of the country had a battle today. Ohio State barely beat Northern Illinois, won that game by 7. So that's what is happening all across college football.
It sure is. I don't know how you're going to predict. I don't think there is any predictions about who's going to be there at the Final Four this year. There's just so many good players in the spread offense, so many big plays in every game right now.
Colbert runs the ball, and that's... Unless there's a penalty, and there is not. That's the final snap of the game. It's over. TCU survives. SMU got to within 5 in the fourth quarter. But the third-ranked Horned Frogs, they get 48 wins against SMU in the battle for the Iron Skillet. 14 of the last 16 won by TCU. First time that Gary Patterson and Chad Morris have clashed. And Patterson's Horned Frogs beat Morris's Mustangs 56-37, your final.
Well, that's the respect right there you saw from Gary Patterson to that young man, Matt Davis, who had a heck of a night. And these two guys, Chad Morris calling the offense for SMU, Gary Patterson calling the defense for TCU, they got a lot of matchups head-to-head going down the road.
Gary Patterson is on the field with Leslie McCaslin. Leslie.
Thanks, guys. Well, Coach, it was a battle there in the second half, but your offense really responded when it counted late. What did you think of the way they were able to turn things around?
Yeah, I mean, that's what older group, everybody back, what they're going to need to do, obviously, going forward. We'll play better. Our kids didn't handle some of the adversity with guys going out, but you got to play the ball in there. We're going to probably play the best passing team in Division I football next week, so obviously we better correct it.
You talk about that adversity. Your guys have faced some of it early on with injuries as well. What do you hope that they take from some close games like this early in the season?
Well, you know, I told them now this SMU, every time I played SMU, it's been a war because they come over here. And so this was not a surprise to me at all. You got to find a way to win. Now you got to go out to Lubbock and start Big 12 play next week. And so take away that they found a way to stop them when they needed to. And we found a way to score when we needed to. And you know, we played pretty decent on special teams. We just got to keep working at it.
Yeah, what would you like to clean up before you go and start conference play next week?
We got to play the deep ball. We're panicking, and it's not that they're running by us. We're not making plays, so we're going to have to make plays.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck.
Thanks, Leslie. There's Derek Kindred. He's got the iron skillet.
There we go. He's a senior. Maybe the last time he holds it.
720 yards of offense tonight. I think 720. I think I'm looking at an AM radio dial, not yardage in a game.
Well, it was one big play after another. SMU, like Gary Patterson said, came over here to win and to compete, and they did all of that. It was a fun night here in Fort Worth.
That it was. And next week, more Big 12 football is on Fox Sports Networks. Rice taking on number 5 Baylor, coverage at 3 Eastern. For Brian Baldinger and Leslie McCaslin, I'm Mark Bolliwell. Thanks for watching here in Fort Worth, Texas. This has been a presentation of Fox College Football. Have a great weekend, everybody.